Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring ding dingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
This is ABC. Turn after these messages.
'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the ship, not a sensor was flashing, not even a blip. When there was a huge crash, to the bridge I then ran, and thereupon St. Nicholas, with joystick in hand, with Atari's Miss Pac-Man, he gobbled and scored. Then on to Jungle Hunt, he played till he roared. From out of his sack, he pulled dozens of games, all the great ones from Atari, our favorite names. Before I could thank him, he beamed out of sight. With a Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night.
I'm freezing! Superman!
Uh-oh, sounds like Lisa and Scott are trapped in the icy cave of that frosty-faced villain, Captain Cold. This is a job for Superman.
My fast freeze zapper will freeze Superman forever.
No way, Captain! Here, kids, my new Superman Hot Cocoa Mix is the super-tasting way to warm up.
Mmm, it's really sweet.
And see, Captain Cold can't take this warm reception. New Superman Hot Cocoa, the super-tasting way to warm up.
We now return with the best of Scooby-Doo.
After these messages.
Presenting Ronald McDonald in No Snow.
To McDonald's we'll go.
I don't see any snow.
Baba, don't start to frown. What goes up must come down.
It's snowing.
To McDonald's we'll go.
What a great time of year.
Snow and sleigh rides are here.
Winter fun once again.
Together with friends.
I don't know which little Debbie to leave for Santa.
I always used to leave oatmeal cream pies for Santa.
You can't go wrong with fudge brownies.
Maybe I better leave them both and let Santa decide.
This holiday season, make sure you have plenty of little Debbie snack cakes on hand. You never know who's going to drop in.
Whenever you get snack hungry, little Debbie has a snack for you.
We now continue with the Monchhichis.
Oh, this will be my greatest feat of magic yet. This project is so new and different, even I don't know if it's going to work. Oh, it's certainly coming along splendidly.
Here you go, Whistle.
What do you think this is, the bowling alley? Why did you bring those coconuts in here anyway?
Well, you told me to, remember?
Yes, so I did. I must have forgotten. I'm sorry about that. No harm done.
That's all right, Wizard. What kind of magic are you working on?
Oh, it's a magical machine that will change the lifestyle of all the Monchhichis. The Wizard's Coconut Milker.
Coconut Milker? How interesting. Can you show me how it works?
Oh, gladly. You see, once the machine is magically activated, these clamps will pick up the coconuts and hold them steady. Then the fine grills will pierce through the shells, the coconuts will be rotated thusly, and the milk will pour out into these tubes where it will be collected and distributed. Kyla? Kyla? Where'd she go? Oh, well, it's time to activate the machine with my magic staff. Oh, my goodness, now where did I put it? Oh, I can't remember. Oh, well, I'll find it later. I'll just have to give this project a personal touch. Oh, dear, my hands feel stiff. I must be getting old.
Pancho, I got it. I got the Wizard's magic staff.
Good work, Kyla. Are you sure he didn't seem to take it?
Are you kidding? He probably forgot I was even there.
Come on, we'll get it back to him before he knows it's missing. After we're finished with it.
Next, add a teaspoon of baking powder. That doesn't sound like very much baking powder. Certainly hope it's enough.
What you doing, Tutu? Are you baking? Are you going to cook something? Oh, can I have some? Is it going to be yummy?
It's a very secret, Thumpy, so don't tell anyone that I'm baking a cake.
Oh, goody, you have a secret. That's great. I love it. Oh, secret. I love secrets as much as I love cakes.
Now, please give me some room so that I can finish. Now, did I put in the baking powder or didn't I? I guess I couldn't have. It's emptier than empty. I'll have to open up a new box.
I'll get it, Tutu. Okay, let me get it. Don't worry. I get all the good stuff so you can make it real and gooey.
Why, thank you, Thumpy. You can put it in the bowl while I find the mixer. Here it is. It's got to be an extra special cake, Thumpy, because today is the Wizard's birthday, and I'm baking the cake for his surprise party.
A birthday party for Wizard? Oh, boy, I love old parties and cake. Oh, it's a great... What can I get him for a present?
I think it would be nice if you threw something for the Wizard. I'm sure he'd really, really like... Oh!
You like to draw? I like to draw. I can draw really good. See, do you like my picture?
No, Thumpy. If you want to draw, use a piece of paper.
I'm sorry. I just having fun.
You should never mess up the walls.
Oh, no! My mixer! It's gone wild! I can't stop it!
If you can't behave yourself, then just get out. You'd better leave too, Thumpy. I have loads of things to do.
Okay, I'll go, but can I have some dough? Give me some dough, because I'll make the Wizard a present.
Sure, Thumpy. Just make it somewhere else, okay? Phew. I just hope there aren't any more surprises today.
Now I'll add a peach fuzz lining, and it'll be all ready for the Wizard. It's a good thing I brought the Wizard's staff down for you to measure, Moncho. You might have made the case too big.
Now, wait just a...
Yeah, Moncho, you make a big case out of everything. A big case, that's a good one.
All right, Patchett, where's your present for the Wizard?
Right here in my trusty tool pouch. Oh, somewhere. It's gotta be here.
Come on, let's get the others. Hey, Tutu, let's get rolling.
I'll be out in a minute, just as soon as I finish my cake. I must have used a little too much baking powder.
Oh, if I could only recharge Tutu's motor to make her move a little faster, it'd be a lot better.
By the way, where's Bumpkey?
I'm right here. What did you think of? I mean, where did you... Look here, I made a Wizard cookie for the Wizard.
Hey, it looks just like the Wizard.
The Wizard will love it, Thumpkey.
Yeah, if we ever get there.
Well, at least there should be enough for everybody.
I'll just see if she needs any... No! Help!
Oh, Moncho, thanks ever so much for holding the door open.
No problem.
It's so hard to see where I'm going with this cake in my...
Uh-oh, prepare for cake rescue!
Yay!
Ah, shucks, that was nothing. I guess I'm just pretty, you know, fast. Fasten your seatbelts, everybody! We're gonna surprise the Wizard by going up to the back door.
Hocus, crocus, fiddly, knock-knock. Well, something like that. Oh, nothing. Why can't I remember the right magic words? All I want you to do is open coconuts. It works. I did it. I did it all by myself. Oh, there's a coconut. Yes, yes, but save the coconut milk. That's the whole idea. If you can't do it right, don't do it at all. Hey, wait, wait! No, I mean, don't wait, keep working! I command you, start working! Oh, some wizard I am! I'd turn in my magic staff, if I could find it!
The anchors away!
Now, don't make a...
Shh, Moncho, this is supposed to be a surprise!
All together now?
Happy birthday, Wizard!
Huh? Birthday? What birthday?
Why, your birthday, Wizard!
Surprise! Surprise!
Here you go, Wizard. It's my present for you. It's for your birthday.
Oh, very nice. What's it supposed to be?
It's you, Wizard. Can't you see? It's got a hat and it's a Wizard birthday cookie.
Oh, thanks.
Here's my present, Wizard. A combination coconut opener and straw. I invented it myself. No more problems getting the milk out of the coconut. One flick of the wrist, and it's ready to drink. Oh, it's just simple. I love it, huh?
Yeah, simple.
What's this big old clunker do?
Oh, nothing. Nothing really. Just another one of my useless projects.
Moncho and I have a present for you, too.
Right. It's just the thing you've been looking for.
It's a case for your...
Oh, there it is. I was wondering what happened to it.
Very happy birthday, Wizard. I knew we were coming, so I baked the cake.
You've too many candles.
Huh? But I counted the very...
No, that's not what I mean. I'm just getting too old.
Too old?
Oh, my magic isn't working right anymore. I'm forgetting all my spells. Maybe it's time for me to go away and retire somewhere.
Go away? But we need you. Monchia needs you.
Where will you go? I don't want you. You shouldn't go. I want you to stay for your birthday.
I'm sorry, kids, but I don't feel much like celebrating.
He's pretty low. Maybe we should leave him alone for a while.
Let's go out the front door. We'll pick up the copter car later.
Come along, Thumpkey.
Poor, poor Wizard.
All my power's in this magic staff. I just don't have it anymore. They don't need me. This is Cookie would make a better Wizard. I have to get away from here. And this is what I'll use. I'll find some place to be by myself where they will never, never find me.
Poor Wizard. He's really, really sad.
We should go back and cheer him up. Look, something strange is going on up there, and I'm gonna find out what.
Carlo, wait. We should. Well, maybe we should.
How are we going to find the door to the Wizard's lab?
Yeah, he always showed us the way before.
Mm-hmm.
his laboratory.
That one. It's locked too.
Then let's ram the door down.
We can't do that.
The wizard might be in trouble.
Oh, well, very well. Okay, all together now.
Ready? Let's go.
Will you look at that? Is that the wizard? It's not the wizard. It's my little wizard, Cookie.
And he's got the magic staff.
We'll return after these messages.
Why not start their morning in a warm way? Smooth.
Apples.
Creamy.
Peaches and cream.
I feel better when he eats a warm breakfast. And Quaker's flavors make it easy.
With instant Quaker oatmeal, you can really make their morning.
Captain O.G. Remor here. Do you feel bored and restless, like nothing's going right? I guarantee that reading books can help you change your life. Learn how to make and do things. Oh, look at that. Learn interesting new things. Oh, I didn't know that. Find adventure and excitement. Things to feel and things to be. Oh, yes, a book can really change your life. Just read a book. You'll see.
We now continue with the Monchhichis.
The wizard's magic must have brought the cookie figure to life.
We've got to stop before he ruins everything. Grab him.
Where'd he go?
He disappeared.
There he is, up there.
Not for long. Huh? I've got you now, you half-baked cookie.
Well, Mancho, you really take the cake. You take the cake. You get it?
Get it!
Where are you, Wizard? Answer us!
Wizard, can you hear us? You know where the copy car is? It was here. I saw it. It was here. And the Wizard was here. And now they're both gone.
I got him! I got him! he's got me. Or it's got me.
I'll rescue you, Patch. Oh, wow. Hey, maybe you better rescue me.
We've got to get that magic staff away from him.
How are we going to get him now?
Look out! I think he's going to get us.
Whoa!
Where are we?
Can't you tell? We're in the Snicker Picker. We must have fallen right through the floor into the Happy Works. Oh, it's the juice that makes everything seem funny.
Well, this is no laughing matter. I'm worried about the wizard.
Oh, me too. He must have taken the coaster car somewhere.
Yes, but how do we get out of here?
Simple. I'll pull the plug and we'll slide out safely. Through the drain.
Controls all set, Patrick.
All set. We'll find the wizard and bring him back.
Lift off!
Level her up at the wizard's place, Kyla. What's going on?
I don't know. Whoa, whoa, whoa!
A little more practice and she'll be good enough to enter the wrecking derby. Meow!
She's doing her very, very best while you're just lying down on the job. I just hope they find the wizard very, very soon.
You know something, Tutu? My cookie was I need is not very nice. It makes me scared.
There's no need to worry about the cookie boy, Thumpy. He won't come down here. Choo-choo, why don't you take Thumpy out to play, huh? I've got to figure out a way to stop that sneaky slab of dough.
Okay, Moncho. Come along, Thumpy.
How am I going to get up to the Wizard's lab to catch that crummy cookie? Uh-oh. Now he's down here tying up traffic. You! I'll get you yet! Hey, you can't do this to me! Wait! This is my car!
There he goes! Stop him! Glad you dropped by, Moncho! The cookie boy is heading for the Happy Works!
Oh no, not the Happy Works! Hey, we've got to head him off! Lock!
I hate to even think what's going on in there. Kyla and Patchett better bring the Wizard back soon, or Monchia is finished.
We've looked all over the Underland, and there's no sign of the Wizard or the copter car.
Maybe we're just looking in the wrong direction.
Good idea. We'll look above the clouds.
Over there. It's my copter car. The Wizard's parked on a cloud.
Wizard, are we ever glad to see you?
Do you mind moving over just a bit? You're blocking the sun.
But, Wizard, we need you.
Oh, this is the first time in centuries I've been able to get out of that stuffy lab to get a tan.
The cookie figure Thumpy made for you has your magic staff.
And it came to life, and it's using your magic staff.
And it's causing a lot of trouble in Monchhichis.
Oh, what can I do? My magic's no good anymore. You'd be better off with a new Wizard. Now, go away and leave me alone.
But...
Forget it, Kyla. He's not coming.
That's what he thinks. Come on!
We'll return after these messages.
McDonald's gift certificates, 50 cents each, or a book of 10 for $5. Something special for someone special.
You deserve a great today. At McDonald's.
It's a world of celebration, joyful yuletide expectation, where peace and love are felt throughout the land. It's an M&M's chocolate candy season. Moms and Santas know the reason. The milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
All the world loves M&M's. They're pure milk chocolate joy for everyone.
M&M's chocolate candies. The milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
We now continue with the Monchhichis.
Sorry about this, Wizard, but it's for Monchia.
Now, why didn't you tell me he was fooling around in my laboratory?
But we tried.
Oh, we've got to find that slab of dough quickly and get my magic staff away from him. It's the only way to stop this infernal interference. My magic crystal is just what I need. You'll find that cookie creature in the Happy Works. Oh, no! Oh, you go ahead. I'll be down just as soon as I can halt this madness.
You got it, Wizard.
Wait for me!
Oh, my! Stop! Stop, I say!
The cookie boy is in the Happy...
We know! We saw it in the Wizard's crystal.
Give me a hand!
on, Patrick. Coming, Muncho.
Where's the Wizard?
He's back up in his laboratory.
Putting everything back the way it was.
It's open. Let's go.
Look at that. I mean, you can't look at that because there's nothing to that. It's all gone.
He vaporized the happy birds.
Shh. Everyone be quiet. Hear that?
But where is it?
It's all here, and in perfect working order. It's just invisible.
Invisible? But where's that kooky cookie now?
Get back. Back inside, I say. That's better. Oh, am I tired. You give me back my magic staff.
Wow, there's the cookie boy, and he's having it out with the Wizard.
He needs reinforcement.
Kyla! Hey, wait for us.
Give it all you got, Wizard.
Yeah, I'll float that cookie down here and give him a good chewing out. Oh, it was no use. The magic staff is more powerful than I am.
But you're the very best Wizard in the whole world. You can't give up.
Not yet, anyway.
No, Kyla, don't.
I'll get your book of spells, Wizard.
Got it.
Here, Wizard. Start reading.
Defy not the Wizard. You're out of your class. The staff isn't working. It's now out of gas.
Hooray!
We won!
I'll take that. It's lost all of its powers anyway.
Oh, no, Moncho. The magic staff is as powerful as it ever was. The spell just made the staff appear as if it wasn't working.
You mean he could... I could have... Well...
Hey, everybody, take a look at my... Look at me, it's my cookie Wizard. He's on the floor, see, as hard as a rock.
Say, I bet it would make a good doorstop. Make it...
You did it, Wizard. You saved Monchhia. You're the very bestest Wizard in the world.
Well, I guess I still have what it takes after all.
And anytime you forget a spell, you can always look it up in your book.
Well, this goes for a celebration.
But your birthday cake looks all... wonderfully beautiful.
In the cookie. Well...
Fooled you. It wasn't the cookie boy. I took the magic staff and you weren't looking. I did it. It was me.
Yeah, I ought to scold you, Thumbkey, for taking it away. But I never scold anyone at my birthday party.
Oh, boy, a birthday party. Do you like parties? I love parties. Oh, I want to blow out the candles. Can I help?
Thanks, Thumbkey, but I don't need any help to blow out the candles. 1,000 candles is nothing to a young Wizard like me.
Happy birthday, Wizard!
We'll return after these messages.
I'm Cubert, and I've got all the right moves. I've got the legs, too. First an arcade game, now my own home video game. I'm ready for anything. Staying away from creeps like Ugg and Coily takes a quick mind and lots of fancy footwork. The longer I hop around, the more they're out to get me. Ugg! When they said fame would go to my head, they weren't kidding.
Now for all popular systems.
Not easy being Hubert, but it's fun.
Gentlemen. Turn on your lights.
Slam Shark Camaro, Avenger Competition Mustang, Sabertooth Tiger Datsun CX. They're powered by your fist, and if you want to race in the dark, you turn on just one switch. Each sold separately, AAA battery not included. Lighted Slam Shifters, Slam Shark Camaro, Avenger Competition Mustang, Sabertooth Tiger Datsun CX. Each sold separately from Ideal.
We now return with the Little Rascals.
Mm-hmm.
should bring you lots of business, huh, Spanky? You bet, Alfalfa, and the job will be a cinch. Hey, Buckwheat, unwrap a stick of gum for me, will you? Sure, Spanky. This is gonna look terrific, if I say so myself. Well, I'm almost finished.
Uh-oh, nobody's on time.
What'd he say? He said we're finished, all right. Here comes Butch and Warren. They'll ruin everything! Hurry! Looks like some fish flopping out of water.
Yeah, fish.
We got some fishing to do ourselves, but not with you turkeys.
Yeah, turkeys.
Oh, Butch, Butch. Ah, gee, it's my mom. We're never gonna get fishing. I hope they catch a whale.
Yeah, and it swallows them whole.
Oh, boy, the first free day I get to go fishing, and I have to push my baby brother around.
Hey, Butch, look!
Huh? Banky's babysitting service ink. This must be my lucky day. Hello, gentlemen, lady, and mutt.
What can we do for you, Butch?
Since you're in the babysitting business, I'm gonna give you the business. You're gonna babysit my little brother's bike.
I need a moment to confirm with my associates.
Oh, what a sweet little baby.
Of course. We'll take care of him.
Huh? Well, I guess a customer is a customer.
Then that settles it. See you later, suckers.
Just a minute, Butch. That'll be $1 payable in advance.
A whole buck? In advance?
That's our policy.
Okay, here you go. But I'll be back later to check up on a little spike. And you guys better make sure you take good care of them.
Don't worry. We've got lots of experience. We were babies once ourselves.
Yeah. You'll be minced meat if you're not careful. What luck dumping a little spike on those yo-yos.
Yeah, yo-yos.
That little monster will make them wish they never went into the babysitting business.
Hey there, little fella.
Poor kid must be a little excited. Here you go, Tiger. Try this.
Oh, the poor little baby must be starving. I'll let him eat up his bottle.
I've got just the thing to stop this crying. Come on, Porky. Here, Alfalfa. The tools on the babysitting tree. Maybe he's just tired and needs a quiet place to nap. What do you think?
Thank you.
He's sleeping.
Since when did my little brother start snoring like a dog? Hey! What's going on? Where's my little brother?
Yeah. Well, you see, Butch, he sort of disappeared.
Disappeared? No one loses my kid brother. I'm gonna go back to fishing now. And if you haven't found Spike by the time I return, I use you for fish bait.
Oh, what are we gonna do? We gotta find little Spike.
Hey, everyone, look who I got.
Wow, there's Lil Spike. Where'd you find him, Buckwheat?
Well, I was testing my new invention, the Buckwheat Baby Buddy, when Lil Spike here crawled in. He loves music.
I hope you boys will keep a closer eye on Lil Spike while I go to my piano lesson.
Keith, you are Spike. Make sure he doesn't get into any trouble. That's an order.
Now, to figure out what to do with our babysitting profit.
How about a new baseball?
I can use a new screwdriver.
How about a bicycle pajama jasper?
What did Porky say?
He said, how about a super duper double decker pizza burger delight?
What's the matter, Pete?
Oh, no! We're gonna lose him again!
Into the car, everyone!
Return after these messages.
The L's are gone from our alphabet.
Must be Nasty McEvil. Let's get him. Post-alphabet cereal. Part of this nutritious breakfast. It's doggone good.
Now you can play with two new Alfie rescue scenes with alphabet stickers.
Nasty, silly me.
One set of stickers in each specially marked box of post-alphabet cereal.
Lotso Hug and Bear gives you lots of hugs and lots of love and lots of fun, no matter where you are. All he wants is a little love, and he'll be your friend forever.
I love you, Lotso Hug and Bear.
From Huggin' Toys.
Wow, this is fun! You keep warm if you pull your hat over your ears, Dollar. No, not over your eyes. You can't see where you're going. Poor Dollar. You just can't take the cold. Say, how'd you like to take a nice, warm, tropical cruise?
Oh, yelp.
$2, but we can keep in touch with my mini TV transmitter. So long, Dollar.
Yelp. Oh.
Goodbye, Dollar. Goodbye.
I am the Count von Schultze.
And I am the Countess, his wife.
What an honor.
Oh, royalty on the same boat with us.
We are Mr. and Mrs. Buckerfeller.
Delighted. Charmed. Yuck.
How awful. A dog on our boat.
How revolting.
Leave, you mangy mutt. Canines are not welcome aboard the rich boat. Who will?
Hi, Dollar. What can I do for my one and only dog?
Richie Rich's dog? Oh, I had no idea. Richie Rich's Dollar Dog.
It's so reassuring to know one's jewels will be safe on the rich boat.
Fantastic! $1,000,000 worth of jewels.
And tonight, we steal them all!
And best of all, we can drop the phony accents. And look who's right next door. A perfect setup. We'll use the Mutt's cabin to sneak into the Buckerfeller suite.
And the dog gets the blame!
I believe I'll have the duck a la Paris.
I wonder how the roast beef is.
Oh, yummy.
How uncouth. I want that animal removed from the ship immediately.
Perfect. Both the Buckerfellers and the Mutt are out of their rooms. Let's get those jewels.
This is gonna be a cinch. We got him. Let's go.
Jewels gone!
I knew it! That dog must be trained to steal things! Why, you goose! Stop! Thief! Help! Police! Coast Guard! The Navy! Call the Marines! Keep searching! We must find that Bow Wow Bandit!
Hi, Dollar. Having fun? What's wrong?
And to think that canine jewel thief had me believing he was Richie Richard's dog.
I get it. Some jewelry was stolen and they think you did it. No time for me to get out there and help, Dollar. Just do what I say and we'll find the real crook.
Yelp, yelp, what?
Climb up to the crow's nest.
Hey, hey!
Now, scan the ship with your TV collar. Good work, Dollar. You found the real jewel thieves.
Now to make a clean getaway.
After them, Dollar.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, no, no.
Dollar, look out!
The cables are tearing from the extra weight!
Help! Somebody save us!
Jewels! You got them back!
You're wrong, Mrs. Buckerfeller. He got them back. Dollar, you're a real hero. You caught the crook.
Psst, Dollar, you're a hero. Take a bow.
And the ship's medal for bravery goes to our hero, Dollar.
Here are all my jewels. I want to buy that adorable dog for my very own pet.
Forget it. There aren't enough dollars in the world to buy my dollar.
Oh, yeah.
Cut it out.
We'll return after these messages.
If you want to be a right good trucker, son, here's what you gotta do. You're in control on US 1 where the trucks go roaring through. Where you hit the road and you move her down. Where you dump that load of jockey rigs around. And you back that truck when you hear that sound of the fire alert. And it's coming down. You heard me. With three trucks. Those trucks mean business, boy.
US 1 Fire Alert Electric Trucking. With everything shown here, you put it together. New from Tyco.
My new car looks great, but it's got so many interesting features, I'll never be able to check them all out.
Hello, Cousin Richie. How's your dumb car?
It's okay, but please don't kick the tires.
Why not? Are they gonna kick back?
That's one feature I hadn't checked out. I just love looking at Dad's collection of rare coins. Look at this one, Dollar. A genuine plugged nickel.
Oh, gosh.
rolling away and into that mouse hole. We've got to get it back. That's Dad's favorite coin. Here, Dollar, let me help. This calls for Professor Keenbean's shrink atomizer. Watch! This won't hurt a bit. Now let's get that coin. Will you look at this place? It's filled with all the things we've ever lost. There's the watch I couldn't find. And there's Mom's makeup mirror. And that's Irona's hairnet. This place is a regular lost and found. Dollar, look out!
Who are you?
I'm Richie Rich.
Oh, the big cheese.
Say, I remember this car. I lost it 3 years ago.
Finders keepers, losers weepers. And what brings you to Mouse Country?
I'm looking for a rare coin that just rolled in here.
You mean this one?
That's the one.
Tough luck, pal. I'm using it for a tire.
But that coin is priceless.
It's priceless to me, too. This is my getaway car.
Getaway car? What's there to get away from in here?
That!
That's it! A magnifying glass! Okay, Dollar, now growl! Come on, Dollar, let's get the coin back into Dad's collection. There, as good as new. Dollar, isn't the shrink stuff neat? Maybe we can do it again.
Okay, who's the wise guy?
Build a nest.
Let's go watch.
There's the nest.
And there's the robin. How snooty it looks.
You'd be snooty too if you had a nest like that. That robin's been flying into Mom's window and carrying off her jewelry.
Richie,
I wanted you to see Professor Keenbean's latest invention, Snack-O-Vision. How about hamburgers?
Oh, yeah.
I just love hamburgers.
Okay, how about French toast?
Oh, boy, that's what I want.
Me too.
No sooner said than done.
Gee, there's hardly any honey left.
That's okay. Dollar will get us some.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
He's in our lunch. Did you hear a strange noise?
It sounded like it came from the professor's laboratory. Let's go find out. So that's why the bees acted so strangely.
Well, yes, I was testing my latest invention, the microwave insect communicator. With it, I can talk to any bug in the world.
Could I tell the mosquitoes not to bite?
Why, certainly, and they'd obey.
Oh my gosh, Richie, what's that?
It's some kind of giant bug.
I am King Bee.
King Bee?
Yes. Now hand over that communicator.
Well, never. If this fell into the wrong hands,
it already has. With this as my crown, I am truly King Bee, for now I shall rule all of the insects of the world.
You'll never get away with this.
Oh, no? Watch this. Now, my lovelies, do as I command.
It's honey. Thanks for licking us clean, Dollar.
Gee, Richie, what do you think King Bee's gonna do with that bug-talking gadget?
Let's check the crime scanner and see.
In Paris, the Eiffel Tower is under attack by millions of spiders, and King Bee says he'll have them bullet down unless he is paid 100 trillion francs.
Here in New York, King Bee's troops have invaded the stock exchange, and there's King Bee himself.
Kill me, mortals. Witness the power of King Bee.
It's sucking up all the stocks and bonds.
Come, my loyal followers.
King Bee has stripped the stock market to the bone.
Oh, Richie, this is awful.
King Bee must be stopped, and I think I know how. Here we go, gang. Full throttle forward. Dollar, I told you to stay in your seat.
Oh. Richie, look. It's King Bee's Beemobile.
Give up, King Bee. I'm on your tail.
Richie Rich, you are beginning to bug me. Watch this.
Looks like we're in for a dogfight. Hang on, everybody. Great, we lost it.
We found them again. Ooh, what's that icy stuff?
More honey. Uh-oh, it stalled the engines. We'll need our emergency landing gear. Now to get this honey off. King Bee must have gone back to his hideout.
How will we ever find it?
Simple. This honey will tell us.
It will?
Watch. Prepare for data input.
Input when ready. Not bad.
Where is it from? There it is. We've located King Bee's hideout.
Gosh, Richie, how will we ever find King Bee's island?
He made it easy. Look.
It's shaped like a beehive.
Uh-oh, King Bee's attack troops.
Oh no, more bugs! What are we going to do?
Flea powder? Forget it, Dollar. I'm afraid we've got bigger problems.
Flying termites! And they're eating our plane!
Prepare to abandon aircraft. Dollar, open the escape hatch.
And we don't have a parachute!
real quiet. They heard us.
Giant spiders!
They're shooting webs at us.
We're trapped!
Richie Rich, I warned you, but you wouldn't listen.
You won't get away with this.
That's what you think. Arise, the insects of the world, and blot out the sun!
Blot out the sun?
Yes, and if the Earth doesn't hand over all of its riches, I'll turn the planet into a giant ice cube. Splendid, my pets. Keep up the good work.
Oh, it's getting cold. Richie, what are you going to do?
There's only one thing to do. Richie calling Irona. Richie calling Irona.
Uh-oh, my Richie's in trouble. Hang on, Richie. Here comes Irona.
Who is that?
That's Irona. And wait till you see what she can do.
First, let me slip into something more comfortable. That's better. Now, watch this.
Thanks, Irona. Quick, Irona, the hammer jammer.
Right, Richie.
Stop! What are you doing?
Smashing your chances of getting away with this.
Wait, my children, come back!
What's that?
It's a lasso I made out of the spider silk.
My insect communicator!
Finders, keepers, losers, weepers!
That's my Richie!
Come back, my loyal subjects!
Looks like your loyal subjects have buzzed off.
You may have the communicator, but you don't have me.
We'll see about that.
Oh, ow! Stop that. I am your ruler.
Take that crook directly to jail.
And do not pass go.
That takes care of King Bee.
Now how do we get home?
Simple. Watch.
A flying carpet.
The carpet has bugs. When we get home, I'll vacuum it.
Well, now we can finally finish our French toast.
Dollar, would you please pass the honey?
return after these messages.
From the planet Grazebow.
Take us to your power forest.
Certainly. You must be hungry after your long journey. Follow me.
The stupid pack twerp has fallen for our little Martian trick.
Yeah, Mesmeron will give us a genius trophy this time.
Well, this is it.
Ha! We ain't no Martians.
Yeah, we fooled you.
Oh, no, you didn't. Hope you enjoyed my little film.
We've been double-crossed.
It's worse than that. We've been triple-crossed.
Come on, let's take that smile off his face.
Now would be a good time for a between-meal snack. Power pellets, that is.
There must be a good hiding place around here somewhere.
I kind of like this one myself.
Inside the projector.
I always love a good ghost movie.
Help! Help!
I gotta get out of here.
Okay,
you're out.
So long, fellas. Better luck next time.
Where are those confounded ghost monsters? Now, who could that be? Special delivery. Do not open until doomsday. I wonder what it is. Like I opened it right on time. It's your doomsday, all right.
You see, it was like this.
No, it wasn't. Don't you ever lie to me again. Lucky for you, something more important has come up. Pac-Man may have his power forest protected against my satellite scanners. I've detected some power pellet energy somewhere else. I'm correct. Wild power forest growing somewhere in the Pac Alps.
No sweat, boss. We'll find it for you.
I don't plan on sweating. I'm coming with you.
Just one last power pellet.
Pac-Man!
Oh. Oh, hiya, Grump. What's up?
Me! I'm up to here with your playing around when we've got an emergency.
Emergency? What emergency?
I just got this telegram from our lookouts in the Pac-Alps.
Oh. According to this, there may be a wild power forest growing in the snow up there. I'd better find it before Mesmeron hears about this.
Good thing he didn't read this orange gram about the abominable Pac-Man monster that was also spotted up there.
The abominable Pac-Man? Oh, well, on second thought, I think I'm coming down with a case of the sniffles. You better send somebody else.
Get going!
Are you sure it's safe up here, Packy? I heard abominable snowmen are very dangerous.
Oh, there's nothing to worry about, Peppa. I've got everything under control.
Don't tell monsters, sing this song. Doo-dah, doo-dah. Chomp and Pac-Man all day long. Oh, doo-dah day.
Peppercorny singing and keeps hurting.
Right, boss. Hey! I think I see the wild power forest. Look, a power pellet tree. Let's give it a shake, Binky.
Hey, cut that out.
Those aren't power pellets, Frostbite Brain. It's a snowball tree.
Oh, well, look on the bright side. Think what would have happened if it was a bowling ball tree. I didn't think they bloomed in winter.
We're losing time. Let's keep looking.
Hey, fellas, look, it's Pac-Man and Ms. Pac.
They must be looking for the wild power forest as well. They'll find something else instead.
I don't see any power forest, Packy.
Me neither. All I see is, snow.
Packy, look!
Season's greetings from the ghost monsters.
Hurry, Pepper! It's gaining on us!
I think it's time to split!
Hey, Clyde! Is it supposed... is it supposed to snow today?
Nope.
In that case... I think we're in big trouble!
I still don't see any wild power forest, Packy.
Don't worry, Peppa. I got everything under control.
They're headed this way. Just do exactly as I told you, and we'll have no more trouble from Pac-Man.
All right, Inky, let's have that saw. Here you are, Clyde. You nincompoop! Where are we gonna plug this thing in?
Simple. All we gotta do is use our brains.
Boy, Pac-Man and his pretty wise skate crossed that circle of ice. They'll be finished.
Hold it, Pepper. My super security senses tell me there's a trap around here somewhere.
That's correct, Pac-Man. And you're standing right on it.
Uh-oh. I think I made a boo-boo.
You sure did. And in about 3 seconds, you're going to be 2 frozen Paxicles.
3, 2, 1, 0.
I wonder how they did that. Well, there's nothing around here but snow, snow, snow.
And nothing to do but chop, chop, chop!
Come on, Packy. It's time for a little hot dogging.
If we don't speed it up, we're going to be in big trouble.
We got it now!
It's the abominable Pac-Man! Pepper!
Packy, help!
I'm coming, I'm coming!
And we're chomping! Ha! We did it!
Yes, we've gotten rid of Pac-Man for good!
Oh, my...
Do you see what I see?
It's the frozen power forest.
And we took care of them, didn't we? Get off me, you freaking fool!
I thought I wasn't going to make it. I guess I didn't.
Shoo! Get away! I'm allergic to chomp.
All right, Pinky. Better do something before they chomp your brains out.
Let's get out of here.
Have a nice day!
Time to make like a bird and fly! Whoa!
Well, looks like we found the Wild Power Forest, and Mesmeron and the Ghost Monsters found a new friend?
Help! Get it away from me! Somebody
help me! We'll return after these messages.
There's something new from Atari.
It's a password.
Snoopy and the Red Baron. Yeah!
Atari presents a challenging new video game for kids. It's Snoopy and the Red Baron in a dogfight.
What's the password?
Snoopy and the Red Baron.
Oh, Andy.
How about I play winners?
Dad, the Flint Club's for kids.
One game. Fenwick. Hi, Chris. Hi, Donnie.
Snoopy and the Red Baron from Atari. Console sold separately and hooked up by an adult.
Luscious apples, red and ripe. It's in here, brown sugar and cinnamon.
Mix and eat.
Mix and eat's the only instant hot cereal where all the flavors are all natural.
Real rich maple, so naturally good. It's in here, plump raisins, a touch of spice.
Ooh, so nice.
All the natural taste you're savoring, it's in here.
Mix and eat cream of wheat instant hot cereal. All the flavors are all natural.
Mix and eat.
Now, here's my idea. I'm gonna smear this blueberry jam across the road, and when Pac-Man walks through, we'll follow his footprints to the Power Pellet Forest. Ah, you dummies! Stop pulling!
Looks like you guys got yourself in a real jam, huh? Is supposed to have the best packed burgers in town, Pepper.
Sounds great, Packy. I'm starving.
What'll it be, Mac?
We'll have two Wukka Wukka burgers and a couple of Pack Colas.
Coming right up. Okay, fellas, go for it.
All right, you guys. Esmeron said that we gotta bring back Ms. Pac-Man, and that's just what we're gonna do. Here's the plan.
This sure is good.
Hey, what time is it? Uh-oh, I've got to get back to work.
Oh, what a face. You ought to be in pictures.
Yeah, I could make you a star.
You could?
You ready for that screen test?
Sure am, CG.
Oh, gosh, isn't this exciting, Packy? Me, in the movies.
I don't know, Pepper. There's something about those guys I don't like.
Miss Pac-Man screen test, take one!
Hey, how'd you know her name?
The Ghost Monsters!
Action! Fall in, men!
Inky!
Inky!
Winky!
Clyde!
Let's chomp Pac-Man before he can hide!
What luck! A power pellet gumball machine!
Pac-Man's the name, chomping's my game!
Pac power!
I think I'd better mail myself to Zanzibar!
Mailman, looks like your stamps need canceling.
Can't get us. Hello? Oh, it's for you.
I know.
Quick, take us anywhere.
Sorry. This cab is taken by me. Now that they're taken care of, I've got to find Pepper.
Those ghostly idiots are due back in 1 hour. They fouled up as usual. They should be back just about now. Get in here! Well, where's Miss Pac-Man? Don't tell me you forgot the camera! Well,
you told us not to tell you we forgot the camera!
Idiot! You ruined my plans!
In that case, you won't be needing this film!
Give me that! It worked!
Let me out of here, you no good Pac-Napper!
Until I learn the location of Pac-Land's power forest!
Nothing you could do would ever make me tell you!
Well, in that case, I'll just have to use my secret weapon! A bionic Pac-Woman!
Good afternoon. I am a simulated mobile electronic pack duplicate. Batteries not included. Ms. Pac-Man? Ha! You are nothing but a cheap copy of me! Wrong. I am better than you.
This is the bionic Pac-Woman's remote control. Now, do as I told you, and be careful with it.
Don't sweat it, boss. We'll trick Pac-Man into giving us the location of the power forest before you can say... You said it!
Hello? Pepper? Where could she be?
I'm right here, Packy.
Where have you been?
Sorry, I had to powder my circuits. My nose.
That bionic beauty is working like a charm.
Yeah, I'll just give a twist on this whatchamajiggy.
See you later, Pepper. I gotta get back to work.
Wait, let's dance.
Whoa, wow, wait, whoa.
You turned the wrong knob, Clyde. This is the one we want.
How about a game of basketball?
Hey.
Gee, I'm awfully sorry, Packy. I don't know whatever got into me. Speaking of power pellets, where is that cute little power forest anyway?
What? You know where it is, Pepper.
Of course, but I just love to hear the way you say it.
Hey, if I don't get to work, I'll get canned.
How about if I go to work with you today?
But all I do is guard the power pellets. It's boring.
I like being bored. It's exciting.
Huh? Oh, okay. Come on.
We did it. We did it. They're headed for the power forest.
Yeah. Now all we have to do is follow them.
North on Pack Coast Highway. Left at the bridge.
What are you doing?
Just taking notes for my diary.
At the Power Forest.
We shall arrive.
On our bicycle, Bill.
For five.
Come on, step on it, guys. We're coming to a hill.
I think we lost them, Clyde.
No kidding.
Afternoon, Pac-Man, Miss Pac-Man.
Well, here we are.
Yes, and now that I know the location of the Power Forest, I must return and tell Mesmerine.
What? You mean you're a traitor?
No, I am a simulated mobile electronic pack duplicate. Batteries not included.
Ah, so that's it. Mesmerine must have pack-napped Pepper and replaced her with that computerized clone. Hold it right there. I'm placing you under arrest.
And I'm placing you under a tree.
Ooh, yummies for my tummy. Time to make like a packed turkey and gobble, gobble, gobble. Figure a way to get Ms. Pack back. Well, I'm not as cute as Pepper, but it'll have to do.
Where are those blundering ghost monsters?
Here we are.
Well?
We lost them.
I'm not surprised. Fortunately, my bionic pack woman is programmed to cover your foul-ups.
Ah,
here she is now. Did you find the Power Forest? Well, are you going to tell me where it is?
Only if you let me see Miss Pac-Man, so I can give her what's coming to her.
Oh, all right. Doesn't matter now. Your bionic friend here wants to give you a little chomp.
Yeah, a little chomp of power pellets.
Pac-Man!
Pac-Man!
Pack power!
Get them!
You get them! We're getting out of here!
Quick, turn on that laser camera!
You're not getting away from me that easy!
You wouldn't chop a defenseless ghost picture, would you?
There ain't no place to hide around here.
I know.
Now, where did that pinky go?
Just as I thought.
Ghost germs. And here's the vaccine.
I ain't no jerk. I'm getting out of here fast.
And I'm gonna chop you even faster.
Hey, that looks like a safe place to hide.
No safe's too tough for Pac-Man to crack. Can't seem to get the last number.
It's not a six.
Thanks.
I got you this time.
That's what you think.
Well, another day, another chump.
Tell me one thing, Packy. How could you ever mistake that phony pack robot for the real me?
Oh, don't be ridiculous, Pepper. That bionic bozo didn't fool me for a minute.
Hello, Packy.
Hi, Pac-Man.
Hiya, cutie.
Pepper? Oh, just kidding. I knew you were the real one. You? You, Pepper, you, oh, wait a second, you.
We'll return after these messages. Presenting Ronald McDonald in No Snow.
To McDonald's we'll go.
I don't see any snow.
Oh, but don't start to frown. What goes up must come down.
It's snowing.
To McDonald's we'll go.
What a great time of year.
Snow and sleigh rides are here.
Winter fun once again.
Together with friends.
McDonald's. Ronald and you.
Two more smash hits from Atari.
The centipedes are coming. Get your fingers moving fast. And the spiders like to get you. Do you think that you can blast? The scorpions are dancing and they're freezing like a jet. If you're looking for some action, centipedes, the game to get.
And get Ms. Pac-Man with four screens, floating fruit, even pretzels.
Honey, don't you know I'm more than Pac-Man with a bow?
Centipede and Ms. Pac-Man, only from Atari. Turn after these messages.
Now, on your breakfast table, Donkey Kong brand cereal.
Crunchy barrels of fun for breakfast. Donkey Kong. Woo! Donkey Kong cereal.
The sweet, crunchy corn taste will drive you ape.
You love the crunch. Donkey Kong. Donkey Kong cereal. Crunchy barrels of fun for breakfast.
It's part of this complete breakfast.
A Donkey Kong cereal. You love the crunch.
What do you want to call your cookies, Mr. Keebler? Chips what?
Well, let's see. The chips are big.
Chips big.
Wait, they're soft, too.
Chips soft.
Our chocolatey chips are so big and soft, they practically melt in your mouth. We put them in cookies made with real eggs and brown sugar. So we need a name that's special.
Call them Chips Deluxe.
Chips Deluxe.
That's special, or my name isn't Cecil B. Deluxe.
Chips Deluxe, with big, soft, chocolatey chips.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad.
That was a lot of fun. But after 87 times, I get a little bored.
Come on, kids. We're almost at Grandma Ria's town. Enjoy the beautiful Mexican scenery.
If I see one more cactus tree, I think I'll die.
Even Lisa's doll is bored.
Leave her alone.
Rubik had a fun idea.
Hello, Lisa. I'm Rosita.
Oh, boy, that's me.
Oh, I'm glad to see you kids decided to have some fun.
What are you doing, Sparky? It's only a rag doll.
That old rug
Rodriguez lady something else, trying to get those town kids this toy for Christmas.
She's a real Mrs. Santa Claus.
Yeah. Let's get that last load.
Come on. No one will miss that old heap. Vamonos. Let's have some real fun with it.
I'm right behind you, mi amigo. Let's hit it.
A truck? Someone's stealing our truck with the Christmas toys.
I tried to beat you guys here. I must be getting slow in my old age.
You haven't changed, Abuelita.
And I never will. We must keep this for life, huh, kids?
You said it, Grandma.
Boy, we're really excited about spending Christmas with you.
It's gonna be a lot of fun.
You just wait. Old Abuelita has a special Christmas plan for this year.
Oh, Pepito, always a cut up.
Cool! Yeah! You can do it?
Yeah, you can do it!
That looks like fun!
Oh, it is! Every year the kids break the piñata at Christmas.
Yay! All right! Yay! Yeah!
Calling Village Granny! Calling Village Granny! This is important! Come in!
This is Village Granny! Go ahead.
A couple of boys stole a truck loaded with Christmas toys.
Thanks for the information. Over and out.
What is it, Grandma Ria?
Oh, that was my surprise for the town kids. I can't let them get away with it. And I'm going to do something about it.
Well, we're gonna help you. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay. Come on, kids. Vámonos.
This road's kind of dangerous. Maybe we should turn back.
Yeah, come on, Ron. You're not scared, are you?
Well, I'm not kidding, mi amigo. This is more than I bargained for. Watch out! Oh, no! What are we going to do? Help! Help!
Help us!
Have you found the road, Reynaldo?
Uh-huh, right here.
Hey, don't worry, we'll get Matt back.
Marco.
Yeah, you're right. We could load it up with the gold and jewels, and no one will be able to trace us in it.
Gracias, amigo.
What do you kids want for the truck?
Huh? You can have it.
You've got a deal.
Oh, no. Look. What are Grandma Maria's toys doing in the back? Come on. We'd better tell someone so they can get the toys back.
First, we'll dump the toys at the old acid ruin, and then we'll hit the pyramid. What about the curse? Bah, there's no curse, but there is the ruin. Yeah, and by the time the policia find this junk, we'll be long gone with our treasure.
I hope we can find the truck with the toys in it.
We'll find it. We'll hunt them down like bloodhounds if we have to. There's only one road between the truck depot and our town, and we'll be turning onto within a couple of miles.
Oh, great!
Great! What do we do now?
Terrific! Now we're stuck out in the middle of nowhere, and I don't even have my doll to play with.
Don't be concerned, mis niños. Your grandma's always prepared. I thought so. It's the fun belt. And out in these parts, you always carry a spare.
Ay, caramba!
If I wasn't living this, I wouldn't believe it.
We've always got Rubik, remember?
But how do we use Rubik without letting Grandma know?
Simple, hermano. We'll have Rubik push us into town. Yeah!
You boys are doing magnifico.
Yeah, they're real tough.
Oh, it's nothing, Grandma.
When you got Rubik.
Rubik's always glad to help.
We don't have much more to go. The town is just over these hills. We're going after that truck somehow, but...
You must go get the toys. They're in the truck.
Yeah, we wouldn't have taken the truck if we knew it had toys in it.
Slow down, hijos. If you kids took the truck, where is it?
Yeah, and where are the Christmas toys?
We let these guys take it.
That truck is not getting past me.
No, Grandma, stop! You'll get hurt!
I don't think they see you!
Rubik, you gotta do something to save Grandma!
We'll return after these messages.
I'm freezing! Superman!
Uh-oh, sounds like Lisa and Scott are trapped in the icy cave of that frosty-faced villain, Captain Cold. This is a job for Superman.
My fast freeze zapper will freeze Superman forever.
No way, Captain! Here, kids, my new Superman hot cocoa mix is the super-tasting way to warm up.
Mmm, it's really sweet.
And see, Captain Cold can't take this warm reception. New Superman Hot Cocoa, the super tasting way to warm up.
As evening approaches Toothopolis, so do the cavity creeps.
Oh no! Cavity creeps!
Hurry, the crest's up!
Crest gel! Cavity creeps spotted!
We made holes in teeth!
Crest gel, of course that will fix them.
Repelled by Crest gel!
Yay, Crest!
Watch treats.
See your dentist.
And fight the cavity creeps with Crest gel.
Tastes great!
Fight cavities with Crest!
Ahoy! Thanks to my new sweepstakes, this young fellow won 5 minutes in a toy store to get all the free toys he can.
You can win, too, in the Cap'n Crunch Toy Store Sweepstakes. Each specially marked box has a glow-in-the-dark poster.
I'll turn out the light.
If it says you win...
I won!
You'll go on one of 500 free shopping trips. Chance of winning, 1 in 46,000.
Now that's a prize worth checking out.
For a free poster, write Cap'n Crunch, Box 4208, Young America, Minnesota, 55399. Alternate prize, $1,000.
Cariño, and those burros are our best chance.
Yahoo!
Yahoo!
Now I know what the rodeo riders feel like.
We'll never catch up to them at this rate.
We better take a shortcut.
That's the idea, Niño. Up that mountain.
I'm glad there's not a lot of burrow traffic. There's hardly room for us.
It's okay. We'll make it.
Almost at the pyramid.
And I can't wait to put my hands on all those priceless jewels and gold. You hear that, Pedro? Yeah, sounds like an aeroplano. Believe it, amigo, but that old plane is after us. Let's get out of here. That lady in the plane, she's crazy. Loca, 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 crazy.
Return after these messages. Huggable little people. The children giggle when you wiggle them. And have long, soft hair you can brush. Snuggle bums keep you company at night because Mama and Papa light up with happiness when you hug them. Batteries not included. The lovable, giggling Snuggle Bum family from Play School. Each doll sold separately with storybook and brush.
Two new smash hits from Atari.
I've seen hot tubs before, but this is ridiculous.
You can save her in Atari Jungle Hunt. Fight man-eating crocodiles. Outsmart hungry headhunters.
Hi, Jungle Hunt. Please.
And after saving the lady, save the baby in Kangaroo from Atari. The monkeys have Baby Roo up a tree. Only Mama can help with up to four screens, just like in the arcade. Get Jungle Hunt and Kangaroo new from Atari.
Messages. Menudo on ABC is brought to you by McDonald's.
McDonald's gift certificates.
$0.50 each, or a book of 10 for $5. Something special for someone special.
You deserve a great today. At McDonald's.
Next Saturday, this new Menudo song can be seen immediately following the Best of Scooby-Doo on ABC.
I have a very special secret. I'm the only one who knows about tiny people living in our walls called the Littles.
Turn after these messages.
Hey, what happened to your cereal?
Big Bear took it.
Oh, lucky bear, because that was malt oatmeal. Smooth and creamy wheat, toasted malt, iron fortified. Good stuff, Maynard.
Can I have some?
Sure. But why don't you show me that bear first?
Are you sure you want to see it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
More Malt-O-Meal, please.
Man, close the door.
Malt-O-Meal hot cereal, a nice part of a nutritious breakfast.
Alfie, the L's are gone from our alphabet.
Must be Nasty McEvil. Let's get him. Post-alphabet cereal, part of this nutritious breakfast. It's doggone good.
Now you can play with two new Alfie rescue scenes with alphabet stickers.
Nasty, fill in the M.
One set of stickers in each specially marked box of post-alphabet cereal.
Silly film dinky.
There's an empty seat right up here, miss.
Oh, my purse.
Anytime.
Whew, that was close.
It just isn't safe watching movies in the Biggs Theater.
Yeah, and their movies aren't any good anyway. Why, when I was a boy, I spent some time in Hollywood. Learned all about making movies the right way. Lights, camera, action.
We have the equipment. I bet we can make a better movie ourselves.
Wait a minute. I remember seeing an old movie camera and a projector in Henry's attic. But I think it was broken.
Don't worry about it, Lucy. I can fix anything. Plane engines, movie cameras, yo-yos, leaky plumbing.
Yeah, but can you fix broken tongues? I know one that won't stop flapping.
Oh boy, we're gonna make a movie.
And we can be the stars.
Top floor,
and start looking for that movie camera. Now get up there and see what's in this box, Dickie.
Will do, Grandpa Little. Hey, it's in here. Only how are we gonna get it out?
There's a toy fire truck in here. Maybe there's a hook and ladder to lift it out.
Good idea, Lucy. I'll be right there.
A little further. A little more. Oh, that's good.
Okay, Tom. Drop her down. Got it. All the way.
Swing her over. Swing her over.
Tom, look. The winch is getting out.
Quick, grab on and start winding.
That's strange. The vent's open.
Phew! That was close, Stinky!
Close? That was nothing for an expert stuntman like me! Looks like a regular movie studio.
Yeah, and we're gonna make a musical, The Little Wizard of Oz.
Oh, that's kid stuff. Let's do a sci-fi epic with space battles and laser fights and...
Hold it. We'll flip a coin to decide. Call it, Tom.
Heads.
Lucky tails, I win, yay!
Little Wizard of Oz, it is.
Yeah, but there's only one good part in it, and it's for a girl.
Come on, Lucy. Let's make some costumes and turn you into a star.
But what about me?
You'll get to work on the set.
That's not fair.
Don't worry. You'll get to act too.
Dinky. Dinky?
Right here, Grandpa Little.
What are you doing in there?
Cleaning the lens. These fingerprints are bigger than my head.
They're bigger than your brain, too. Now come out of there.
Whoa!
Come on, Dinky. We've got to find a roll of film.
I nearly get sprocket holes in my head, and all he's worried about is a stupid roll of film.
What did you say?
Me? I said, what are you waiting for? We've got to get that film.
Some toothpaste and a hairbrush.
Here, Grandpa Little.
There's the movie film, Dickie.
Don't you think we ought to pay for it first? Do you think this stamp will be enough, Grandpa Little?
It's the best of my collection. And the druggist is a stamp collector, too.
There. Now to see how she flies.
Thank you, Mr. Scott.
Ha! Perfect landing.
Grab hold, Dinky. Quiet on the set. Lights. Camera.
We're rolling.
Action!
Not yet, Slick.
We're wasting film. Action! Action!
What do I say now? Hi, I'm Tom. I'm the Tin Tom, the Tin Man, and this is the Little Wizard of Oz. Hey, I'm stuck!
Hello, Toto. How are you?
Actresses.
honey.
And with my expert camera work, you look like a star up in the silver screen.
Lucy Little the star. I didn't want to make a stupid movie anyway.
All right, Grandpa Little. The film's ready for developing.
Wait a minute. If we have it developed, someone might see us and...
No problem. They just developed the film at those labs. They don't look at it.
All I needed was a little more time to practice my lines.
Tom, bring this film to Henry and have him develop it for us.
Oh, okay. Lucy gets all the praise and I have to do all the dirty work. And then when we get the film back, everyone will see how awful I was and how wonderful Lucy was. You were great, Lucy Little. You're gonna be a star, Lucy Little. Yuck. I hope Henry loses the film. That's it, Slick. I'll wait a day and then tell the others that the film was lost at the photo lab. Hello, garbage dump. Goodbye, film.
We'll return after these messages.
Why not start their morning in a warm way? Smooth.
Apples.
Creamy.
Raisins.
Delicious.
Peaches and cream.
I feel better when he eats a warm breakfast. And Quaker's flavors make it easy.
With instant Quaker oatmeal, you can really make their morning.
It is a pretty tough job. Have you read the label of a fun drink lately? 10% real fruit juice means 90% what? How much of what they drink has any nutritional value? Not sure? You know why we developed new Sip-Ups, the fun drink that takes nutrition seriously. Sip-Ups are milk, and Sip-Ups are naturally flavored in the flavors kids love. New Sip-Ups on your grocery shelf, because what's inside the package goes inside your children.
Okay, hit it, Becky.
We're all ears.
Uh-oh. Aren't you going to play our song for us?
I kind of forgot it.
How about having a bowl of Rice Krispies and we'll give you a hand?
How about a foot?
It's fun to put that crackle pop into your morning.
Now I remember.
Kellogg's Rice Krispies Cereal, part of this complete breakfast.
Into your morning.
Guess I got too keyed up.
This is Candyland, a place you pretend to visit when you play this game. The cards show you how to follow the path through Candyland. You'll discover the gingerbread plum tree, a rainbow pass, and gumdrop mountain. But be careful of the cherry pitfalls, and don't get stuck in molasses swamp. You don't have to know how to read or count to have loads of fun in Candyland. Candyland, a game for people 4 to 8, from Milton Bradley.
Before someone finds me. Get away, you ugly dog. Hunter won't get me after all. If I can just get that big mutt away from the hole. Here, doggy.
Want to nibble on my tail? Here goes nothing. Get it out of the trap.
I can't wait to get the film back. Just think, I can show it to all my friends.
Tom, where have you been? Just out.
Did you give Henry the film?
Sure. Excuse me, I'm going to my room.
Well,
what am I gonna do, Slick? If Dr. Hunter finds that film, we'll all be in big trouble.
And we can have popcorn and candy and sell tickets?
Say, I just got a great idea for our next blockbuster movie, The Adventures of Baron Von Dinky.
Lucy, hi, Mr. and Mrs. Little.
Hi, Henry. When's the film gonna be ready?
Film? What film?
Why, the film Tom gave you to be developed.
Tom never gave me any film.
There's something funny going on around here.
Tom did look a bit strange when he came in.
Come on.
And I left the film in the trap and came back here. I tried to get it back. Honest, I tried, but... I'm sorry. I know I did wrong. I was jealous of Lucy.
Jealous, great grasshoppers. Well, we'd better get it back before Hunter finds it.
Quick, son, show us where you left it.
Whew. It's still there.
But how will we get it out?
No sweat, Mr. Little. All we have to do is dangle someone on the end of a string, hook a line to the film, then haul it back up here. Now, who's gonna volunteer?
I know the perfect one for the job.
Well, not me. I gotta stay up here and supervise.
You can supervise all you want from the end of the rope.
Oh, and Dinky, there's a big dog around here, so watch out.
Now he tells me. Don't they know great pilots are valuable people and shouldn't be wasted on dangerous missions? And something tells me this mission is getting more dangerous by the minute.
It's Dr. Hunter's assistant.
He must be here to check out the trap.
Hurry up, Dinky!
There! That knot'll hold anything! Haul away! Oh, no!
Oh! Hmm. Something was in here. I wonder how this got in the trap.
What'll we do now?
We've got to contact Little Civil Defense Headquarters immediately.
Station 7, I have the van in sight. Peterson is turning onto the highway.
Outpost 4, the van is approaching your sector. Get ready to pick up the surveillance.
I just hope the tracking team doesn't lose sight of that van.
Don't worry, Grandpa Little. I've got our best men on the job.
Oh, no. He's headed into that film processing lab. I'd better head back to town and notify the others.
Hmm.
the film to the lab.
He must be having it developed.
Looks like Dinky and I'll have to sneak into the lab tonight and get that film back. There's the lab, Dinky! Land on the roof!
The film has got to be around here somewhere.
You look that way. I'll try over here. Nope. That's not it. Not that one either.
Maybe this is it. Come on, you stupid film!
Dinky!
Grandpa! Help!
This is it! You found the film, Dinky!
I did? I mean, of course I did. Why, I followed the film right through this machine. Nearly got away from me until I...
Shh! It's a security guard.
There goes our film!
And possibly our future! Took the film.
That means Dr. Hunter will have it in the morning.
And if he goes public with it, it'll show on the news and everyone will know we're here.
It's all my fault. If it wasn't for me being jealous of Lucy, none of this would have happened. I'll just have to get that film back myself.
Think of something.
I know. Let's pack up our things and move to the South Pole. You're right. It's too cold. How about Africa?
What's this? I've gone to get the film back. If I don't return, I'm sorry for what I did. Love, Tom.
He must be headed for Hunter's trailer.
We've got to stop him before he gets caught. Let's go, Dinky.
Thanks.
He's got it!
He sure does.
Lucy, what are you doing here?
Same thing you're doing here. I couldn't let my only brother get in trouble without me.
But this is my problem, Lucy, not yours.
Tom, Little, don't you know that when you love someone, their problems are your problems?
There's Tom, and Lucy's with him.
They must be headed for Hunter's trailer.
We've got to hurry.
Here's the film I found in the trap yesterday, Dr. Hunter.
It's probably nothing. Put it on the projector. We'll take a look, though.
I've got to stop them before they project the film.
Coast is clear.
It's ready, Dr. Hunter.
Now's my chance.
I'll start the film now.
Oh, Tom, your feet are on the light.
Oh, no! Grandpa! Dinky!
This way, quick! Let's unplug it!
It's too late! The littles are doomed!
Just as I thought. It's only someone's trash.
Yay!
especially like the way you made everything come out all fuzzy and dark. Hunter couldn't see a thing.
Nothing to it, though it did take years of experience to perfect my skill with the camera.
I shouldn't have been jealous, Lucy. You're just a better actor than me.
You're better than me at a lot of things, Tom.
Really?
Yeah. Better at making a mess, better at getting into trouble, better at being a nosy brother.
Why, you?
Look, I put everything here.
Good. Let's see Grandpa's instructions. Take a 1-inch cardboard strip of egg carton, 2 buttons and a thread, glue buttons to the ends of the strip. Cut out a shell-shaped cup of an egg carton. Now suspend strip from top of egg cup with a thread looping through and tying to cup. But be careful. The strip must be suspended from the cup and not touch the ground.
It's almost done.
Good. We just have to decorate it now.
Quick, he's coming.
Oh. Happy birthday, Slick. It's a little May turtle for you.
We'll return after these messages.
For my boy, Tommy, we made a most unusual friend. Glider, the flying pup. Because of him, our search led to New York, where we finally found Tommy. He was being held prisoner. Oh my gosh, we came to the rescue. Now we're one big happy family. Me, Tommy, his boats, Duke, Dash, Lucky, and Dolly. But if you think our adventures are over, boy, are you wrong.
We'll return after these messages.
Remember the day when your folks gave you a new box of crayons,
Crayola,
Caddy. So much fun in every pack. How you just couldn't wait. How much fun you create with Crayola. Crayola brings the color back to Christmas.
The Crayola Caddy comes with all the nice things you see here.
Time for Timer, your roving reporter. I'm talking to you from inside Fantastic Factory, your digestive system. You know what we build here? You! Not out of wood or metal, but out of food. You see, you are what you eat from your head down to your feet. Things like meat and eggs and fish you need to build up muscle tissue. Uh-oh. Hello, appetite control. More protein. We need energy. Playing tennis today, you know. Whoops. All these motors in your body need a lot of fuel to go on, like carbohydrates, fats, and proteins, vitamins, and so on. What's left over forms the building blocks you need, indeed, to grow on. Yes, you are what you swallow, so that next time you feel hollow, don't just fill your face with any old kind of treat. This goes for every kid or six-foot athlete. All you really are is what you eat.
Washington, D.C. is a beautiful city, not to mention one of the most powerful places on this planet. All the secrets of our government are here. We came with Tommy and his mom and dad, who are here for an archaeological convention.
Oh, boy, Bang Face, my favorite. You pups are missing the best part.
Okay, you guys, we'll be back later. Be good now.
Bye-bye. Gee, our country's capital. You know, the president lives here.
It makes you feel kind of patriotic.
Doesn't sound like the people in the next room are very patriotic.
Well, that's all you must say. Get that secret and destroy it. Rocket.
Yeah, I wonder what that's all about.
Only one way to find out.
We must have the plans for the solar energy rocket by tomorrow, Gibson. The secret launch is on schedule at 0900 hours.
Secret launch?
Lunch sounds good to me.
I've got the disguises and the van is all set.
Sounds like they're spies. It's something to do with a rocket launch.
It's going to get dark soon. That's the best time to go to Sherman Alley. There we'll be able to find the killer dogs we need to pull it off.
Wonder what they need killer dogs for.
Sure do sound a mite suspicious to me.
Duke, we should do something.
And I know just the way to do it. We're going to go to the Sherman Alley before they do and make sure the killer dogs they get are us.
Isn't that kind of dangerous and everything? I mean, you know, messing around with spies?
It'd be a heap more dangerous for those plans to fall into the wrong hands.
Oh, I hate intrigue and mystery and spy stuff with foreign agents.
Come on, Dash.
Okay, I'm coming. Very slowly.
Cute name. You're quite a ways from your own turf, ain't you, Toots?
Having any trouble, Dolly?
Well, if it ain't the hero coming to the rescue of little Miss Pretty Face. Can't you take a joke? Listen, be my guest. Make yourself at home.
Oh, Petey, you are so brave. It was nothing.
It appears we're in the right place.
Well, well, looky here. Yeah, it looks like we're gonna have lunch today.
Oh, they look like pretty tough customers.
Not tough enough for us.
Them dudes look hungry, Duke.
Well, maybe we ought to put them on a crash diet.
This one's mine.
Hang in there, partner. I'll get you, you little twerp.
Oh, no, you don't.
Over here, Lucky.
Gotcha.
Out of the way for a while.
Thanks. I owe you one.
What's the dang deal? It was just good old-fashioned teamwork, Duke.
Don't you ever read my lips. Pick on a pup.
Well, we've struck gold. Those mutts are just what we're looking for.
Yeah, they'll round out our little crew nicely.
There they are. It's working.
Here you go. Nice doggies.
Oh, brother.
Look what I've got. Some nice steak.
Come on, gang. We gotta play along.
Who's playing? I feel real serious about that steak.
Good, doggies. There you go. Perfect. Just perfect.
We'll leave these little runts behind.
We've gotta follow them, Petey. Follow me! Quick! The cab's pulling out! Jump!
Oh, boy. Not again. Not again.
You new around here?
Oh, right. I'm new.
Well, I don't like your looks.
Yeah, but I'm not too crazy about them myself.
Oh, you didn't want that, did you?
Oh, no. Oh, not me. Oh, perish the thought. No.
He's with us.
You didn't have to go and do that. Another couple of minutes, I'd have had him eaten out of my paw.
Right, Dash.
Like we're gonna have to hitch another rock. There's the van. I don't know. Over there. The truck. It's our only chance. We made it.
Come on, you mutt.
Here, doggies! Get in there!
I think the coast is clear.
Over here, kid.
That's my little guy. I knew you and Dolly would make it here.
It wasn't easy.
Boy, are we in the middle of something?
Yeah, we overheard that these guys are industrial spies. They work for a rival aviation company. They want to steal the rocket plans from NASA, then use them to explode the rocket so it'll look like the design was faulty.
Then their firm will get the contract to redesign it.
But we don't know where the launch is going to take place.
I guess the only way to stop them is when they steal the plans at the NASA building.
That's right, kid. They're going to use us dogs to create confusion so they can slip inside.
Can you be their pups?
You betcha. NASA, they should be here any minute. And there they are. So that's Avery's disguise. Not bad.
Get the fire hoses and the extinguishers. I'll call for backup.
This way, guys.
Get away. Help.
What's going on?
It's okay, folks. We've got it under control.
Where'd these dogs come from anyway? Avery's got the plans. Get him!
We gotta stop him.
Run away, you stupid pup!
I got it, Dolly!
Hey, they've got the briefcase! That little pup's got the plans! After him!
We'll take the plans!
They stole the plans!
City! Everything is messed up!
No fooling. And that's all probably thanks Petey and Dolly were in on it.
Around the corner, Dolly!
There they are! Step on it!
Oh, no!
Come on! They went in there!
We can lose ourselves in here. Come on. Once we shake these characters, we'll figure out how to return the plants.
There they are.
Through these bars. Oh, no. The briefcase. Got it. Now let's move.
Around back. They'll end up around back.
Can't see anything. We'll have to jump on it. You okay, Dolly? I'm right behind you, Petey. Exit. Come on, let's go.
We've lost them.
Our luck has turned for the best. This pup is perfect for our plans. Just enough room in the rocket for a small pup wearing the electronic device to enter. We'll train the little pooch to slip aboard. When the rocket reaches 10,000 feet, that'll be it. I never liked dogs anyway.
First us, now the spies have Petey and the plans. What do we do?
First thing is to get out of here.
Well, dadgum, if I had a thin piece of wire or something.
I think I got something. I hope I can do it.
An old Texas hound like me knows lots of ways of getting out of fixes.
Let's go.
We'll return after these messages.
If Monday's bad or Tuesday's sad, make a Saturday.
That's a Sunday.
If Wednesday rains or Thursday's gray, make a Saturday.
Looks like a Sunday.
Send a half a banana and a pineapple ring. Add yogurt creamy smooth. Pop a grape on top and that's a Saturday for you. Make a weekend treat any day of the week. Make a Saturday.
Now that's a Saturday.
What's up, Wish Bear?
It's a beautiful starry night for riding over Care-A-Lot.
It's the Care-A-Lot playset from Kenner. Care Bear sold separately.
Starlight, Starbright, wish I could find Bedtime Bear tonight. He's not on the slide.
Whee!
He's not under the mailing table. Uh-huh. Found you. My wish came true.
Oops. Gotta get to work while everybody gets to sleep.
Bedtime, girls.
The Care-A-Lot playset comes with everything you see here. Care Bears each sold separately from Kenner.
Open wide.
Dear little baby, your life is so sweet. You can pretend that she's learning to eat.
Want more? Mommy has to mix it.
You can pretend baby alive eats and drinks when you move the lever in back.
Good girl, bottle's all gone. Ooh, my baby needs a clean diaper.
It's fun to baby your baby alive. Sweet darling baby alive. New Baby Alive comes with everything you see here. She's from Kenner.
Thank you.
bring Petey back to the hideout?
I can get his attention.
Am I glad to see you guys?
Are you okay?
I'm fine. Listen, these guys really mean business. They've been teaching me to sneak aboard the rocket wearing this electronic thing around my neck. It's set to cause a malfunction when the rocket reaches 10,000 feet.
Oh, Petey, that's so dangerous.
She's right. We'll change places and I'll go instead.
No, Duke. They think they've trained me. Besides, they need a small pup. I'll let them think I'm trained. Then, once we're in the launch area, we'll be able to expose them.
All right, kid. We'll be there.
You have the passes?
Right in here. They're perfect. I forged them myself.
The countdown must be on schedule. They're clearing the area. We'd better get in there. This way.
Oh, I don't like this. Can't we just call the president or something?
Without Petey and that electronic gizmo, we ain't got any proof.
Let's get a move on.
Okay, the pup.
Okay, Pooch. The rocket. Go to the rocket.
Good. I'm fooling him.
Using that pup was a stroke of genius.
Now, to get to Duke and the others. Uh-oh. This wasn't in the plans.
There they are. Let's get them, gang.
The squad dogs won't find me here. Oh, no!
The pup's on board. Let's get out of here.
What the?
Those dogs!
Now, Lucky. Keep them covered. Petey will be here any minute with the evidence to throw these two creeps in the slammer.
T-minus 30 seconds and counting.
Petey should be here by now.
T-minus 10 seconds and counting.
I don't suppose Petey's...
5, 4, 3, 2...
He's gotta be in the rocket!
And lift off.
I gotta get out of here. There's gotta be an emergency stop switch or something. All right. That alarm's gotta mean something.
The booster's detaching before schedule. We'll have to maneuver it into the Potomac, away from the city. And it's heading for the river.
Those dogs are crazy.
Come on.
I'm going under and get them out.
Not yet, they don't.
Petey, you're okay?
Come on.
I can't believe this.
What's going on here?
What?
Well, what have we here? Looks like these dogs have really given us a hand in capturing Avery and Gibson, I believe.
Boy, Dad, I'm real proud of our dogs. I mean, they saved the whole launch.
That's right, Tommy. They really deserve those medals.
Oh, Petey, I'm so proud. Getting a medal from the president.
Yeah, we all are, Dolly.
To tell you the truth, I'd rather have some of those jelly beans.
We'll return after these messages.
Hungry, hungry hippos, hungry, hungry hippos. If you want to win the game, you gotta take good aim and get the most marbles with your hippo. Playing hungry, hungry hippos. Hungry, hungry hippos.
Hungry, hungry hippos is the name of the game. And who's ever hippo gets the most marbles wins.
Playing hungry, hungry hippos. Hungry, hungry hippos.
Hungry, hungry hippos from Hasbro.
The return of the Jedi and the Underoos underwear spaceship.
We all love our Underoos, so many for you to choose.
Skywalker at control.
Chewbacca.
And Han Solo standing by.
Boy Ewoks are brave.
Girl Ewoks are prettier. See? Princess Leia. On the lookout.
Underwear is fun to wear. It's true when it's you and your underoos.
One night about a quarter to nine, and the gang had said goodbye, and there on the corner all on his own stood our friend Willie Survive. He told the gang he'd take the bus, cause it took him right past home. When he missed the bus, his friends are gone, and now he's all alone. Willie Survive, Willie Survive, Willie Survive. Carried emergency change. He used it to call home.
Hello, Dad. Can you pick me up?
And you should always do the same in case you need to phone.
Scooby-Dooby-Doo, Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are ya?
We'll return after these messages.
This is the Stomper Mobile Force Tank. It comes with a Stomper Mobile Force Bridge Buster set. You have to put the set together. Free battery included.
Enemies block the bridge. Have a squad army. We are going in.
Stomper Mobile Force Bridge Buster set for action with traction on or off the set. The Stomper Mobile Force Bridge Buster set comes with everything shown here, new from Shopper.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Scrooge!
Now with the new electronic talking ViewMaster Viewer, batteries not included, see and hear 3D scenes from Disney's Mickey's Christmas Carol. Just snap in a cartridge.
Ah, humbug!
And the characters look and sound so real.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Scrooge!
You think you could reach in and touch them. See and hear A-Team and Muppets on cartridges each sold separately. The talking ViewMaster Viewer with earphone, volume control, and three Mickey Mouse cartridges.
After these messages.
You can roll a Rolo to your pal.
Chocolate covered chewy caramel.
You can roll a Rolo to your mate. It's chewy and it's chocolate. Really great.
Rolo. Chewy chunks of caramel, each covered in real milk chocolate. All rolled together.
You can roll a Rolo with your friends. It's chocolate covered caramel from end to end.
Ooh. Yum, yum.
There's only one Capri Sun. It's great taste and fun when you punch open one. There's only one
Capri Sun.
It's great taste and fun
when you punch open one.
Lemonade, apple,
orange,
grape, and fruit punch.
Great tasting Capri Sun fruit drink in the take-along pouch. 10% fruit juice, nothing artificial.
There's only one
Capri Sun.
Great taste and fun when you punch open one.
There's only one Capri Sun.
Now, back to our story.
Let's make a wish it'll be better tomorrow.
Rosalind, if wishing did any good, I wish for a new bicycle. This old crate needs a doctor.
You said it, Quentin. We could hear you coming a mile away.
Vincent. Yeah, I probably scared off the fish.
Again.
Yeah, this tire's got more holes in it than a fishing net.
Gosh, Quentin, I wouldn't have time to help you now. I'll be in trouble if I'm late for supper. Yeah, and I've got to get to my piano lesson. You gonna be all right?
Yeah, sure. It's all right. I've done it before. I'll see you guys later. So long.
Okay, see you tomorrow. Bye.
Quack, 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 quack. Well, yeah, but all I've got is a fishing pole, and my line's not strong enough.
I assure you it'll be more than adequate. Would you hurry, please?
Okay, I gotta go get it. I'll be right back. Here you go.
Okay, lad, I'm hooked. Reel me in.
Boy, you sure don't weigh much.
Thanks for saving me life, lad.
Who or what are you?
A leprechaun, lad.
You're a leprechaun? Like the little people from Ireland?
Exactly. Now, the hook, please.
Gosh, a real leprechaun in Cedarville. What were you doing in the hole?
If you must know, I fell in. You see, I've been living under Mrs. Trusker's porch.
Miss Trusker?
Uh-huh.
She's our soloist at church.
Oh, you have me sympathies, lad. That woman's voice is awful.
Yeah.
More like the whooping and shrieking or squawking of a duck. Almost more than me senses could bear.
I can believe it.
So the final straw was when she brought that dog home. He found me, then he chased me, and I fell into the hole. You see, about the only thing a leprechaun can't handle is a dog. They weave a spell of some sort. Not to mention their teeth.
Yeah. What's your name?
Now that's one question I won't answer. Because if I did, I'd have to grant you 3 wishes by the law of the leprechauns.
Great! I love wishes!
Listen, I've got to find another place to live. Would you mind the hook?
Look, I tell you what. If you tell me your name, you can live at my house. My mother makes great Irish stew.
Irish stew?
The best. And you can sleep in our hayloft in the barn, safe from dogs. And nice, warm hay.
Warm hay.
How about it?
Oh, you talk a mighty good bargain, lad. But if I should tell you my name was Flan, then I'd be... Whoops! Now I've done it! Dang, dang, donkey ears!
Flan! That's a great name. I'm Quentin.
Quentin, now you've got your 3 wishes. Think carefully before using them.
Right. Let's go home for supper. That way I'll have plenty of time to decide exactly how to use my wishes. Oh, darn it. I forgot about my flat tire. I sure wish it were fixed.
Well, that's one wish.
One wish?
Exactly.
Oh no! I wish I'd never wished for that. What have I done?
Simple, lad. You've used 2 wishes. You have 1 left.
Oh, no.
Well?
I guess we better walk home while I give my last wish some thought.
Nice warm barn, lad.
I'm glad you like it. Come on, I want you to meet my mom.
Quentin. Have you thought what your 3rd wish is going to be?
Yep.
Oh, be careful, lad.
I wish for all the money in the world.
Thank you. What's happening? Are you all right?
We're okay.
What's all this money? What on earth?
Quentin, who is this?
My name is Flan.
He's a leprechaun.
A what?
You mean like the little people from Ireland?
Exactly.
But aren't you just a legend?
Of course not, Dad. He's real, and he's a friend.
Well, I'll be hog tied. Quentin, you've done a lot of mischievous things, but this is outrageous. What is going on?
Well, Flynn did it for me, Dad.
Every room in the house is full of boxes. They all have money in them.
Yeah, isn't it great? We're rich.
Quentin, this is not our money. We didn't earn it, so we can't keep it. Flynn, I want you to send all of this money back to where it came from. Why'd you do that?
When one is as wee in size as myself, he gets tired of looking up all the time. Now, in answer to your request, I cannot make the money go away.
Why not, Flan? You can do magic.
Aye, but the money belongs to you, lad.
Then maybe I better wish it back.
You can't. You don't have any more wishes.
Wait a minute. Are you telling us we can't get rid of the money?
Afraid not, Mr. Stowe. 'Tis the law of the leprechauns.
Gee, Quentin, I can't get over it. Yesterday, you were just a kid with a broken-down bike, and today you've got all this money.
We interrupt this program to bring you a news bulletin. Reports are coming in worldwide that all the money in the world has disappeared. International trade has halted. The New York Stock Exchange is closed. More details to follow.
Gosh, things really seem bad.
Yeah, and I guess it's all my fault. Last night, when the president was on TV saying all the money in the United States was missing, my folks really got worried.
I'll bet.
Dad got through to the White House and told them everything.
You mean about all this? What are you going to do with it?
I've been thinking about that, and I want to give you and Vincent some of it for being such good buddies.
We don't want money for being friends.
But I want to share it with you, so take as much as you want.
Really?
Yeah, no kidding. Go ahead. Wow! Oh, that's not nearly enough. Get some more. Come on, there's plenty. Come on, put some more in there. Let me help you. Come on, here. There's some more. Come on, there's plenty. Take anything you want. Come on.
Quentin, you're the best friend that anybody could ever have.
Boy, I'll say.
Doing, Quentin?
Yeah, stop goofing around. Are you gonna give us the money or not? Well, yeah, I'm trying. Oh, come on, Quentin, you're making fun of us.
Take as much money as we want, huh? Is this what you do when you have all the money in the world? Make fools out of your friends?
I don't know what's going on. Well, I do. You meet a new friend who gives you lots of money, and your old friends don't mean anything to you.
Come on, Vincent.
Wait a minute! Come back! I didn't play a trick! What happened with the money?
Simple, lad. You wished for all the money in the world. Now, if you have all the money in the world, then no one else can have any.
But I lost my best friends.
You wished for money, Quentin, not friends.
We'll return after these messages.
Slam shifters, die-cast cars. They're hot. They're fast.
You don't push them. You slam.
And now, slam shifters, cannon blaster. Set up the course and slam shift over the pylons. You can load your crash car and lock it in. Measure out the crash course and slam, slam, slam the cannon blaster. Slam shifters and cannon blaster each sold separately from ID.
Ronald McDonald in Good Morning.
Good morning to you. Good morning to you. The sun's shining brightly. The day is brand new.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning to you. The sky
holidays never been so incredibly blue. Your best friends and breakfast are waiting there for you. McDonald's, Ronald and you.
Good morning!
Here are a few words about Levi's jeans and cords.
What kind of Levi's cords you got?
Raspberry and chocolate.
Can I get those to go?
Wow!
Now, back to our story.
Hey, folks. Sergeant, guard that money.
I'm Major General Linus Mainwaring, United States Army. And you, I presume, are Quentin Stowe?
Yes, sir. This is my mom and my dad.
How do you do, sir?
Pleasure to meet you, General.
Ma'am?
Pleased to meet you, General.
We've been expecting you.
Well, then let me get right to the point, Mr. Stowe. I'm here for reasons of security because you called the White House. Therefore, my mission is of paramount importance. Young man, the president of the
Get back!
Mmm, a mighty tasty chocolate!
What in the world is going... Is this the leprechaun you told the president about?
Yep.
Well, you're right. He is a troublemaker.
Exactly.
I'll get rid of that for you, General.
Thank you. Well, anyway, Quentin, the reason I'm here is that you have awaiting you the most important meeting of your life.
I do?
Yes. You have a meeting with the president of the United States, and he'll be here shortly. You... The president also requests your presence.
I'd be honored.
I'm glad you're going to be with me, Flan. I can use your support.
That's what friends are for, lad.
As president, I must tell you the money shortage problem has become very serious. I'm worried about our people who can't get paid for the work they do or buy the things they need for their families. We're even running out of food at the White House.
Oh, no.
Now, Quentin, do you have any ideas that might help us solve our problem?
No, Mr. President, I don't. I should have wished for a new bicycle, and then I wouldn't have caused all this trouble. If only I had one more wish.
Flan, I'm told you have magical powers. What can you do?
I can do that.
No, no, you misunderstand me. I mean, is there a magical solution to our problem?
Maybe there is, maybe there isn't.
And you can't tell me. I see. I see. Flan, would you excuse Quentin and me for a moment?
Of course.
Huh. Flan likes you very much. He hinted there might be a solution. Try and find out what that solution might be as soon as possible.
Yes, sir.
I'm counting on you, son.
Quiet! All quiet!
Banker Sedgwick.
Thank you.
As president of the Cedarville Bank and Trust Company, I can only tell you that conditions have become unbearable. With no money in our vaults, we are unable to conduct business. In 2 days, the schools will be forced to close.
He doesn't care about the schools. He's just worried about his bank vaults.
And so, as banker, I have designed a plan to ease the problems of you merchants. We'll call this play money dillies. Sheriff Arbor will pass them among you.
See what I tell you.
These dillies will be legal tender for all debts and purchases. Till this terrible dilemma is rectified.
I'd like to be the first to pay a debt with these dillies.
Very good, Sheriff.
I owe you $20 or dillies. I gotta get used to that. Remember, you loaned me $20 when my squad car ran out of gas last week.
There, you see, my plan is working perfectly.
What's the meaning of this, Quentin?
I didn't do it. I can explain.
Please do.
Please, please, sit down, sit down, pay attention, sit down. You see, the dillies indeed are play money. But when Sheriff Arbor paid his debt, the dillies, in effect, became real money. Therefore, it all belongs to Quentin, because he owns all the money in the world.
You mean we're never going to have any money again, ever?
That's the way it'll be, Sedgwick.
Hey, hold it, hold it, hold it!
You all right, Slam?
Precious! Oh, darling! Oh, baby! Oh, you ran away again, you naughty boy! What in heaven's name is that?
Would somebody help me out?
Why don't you just pop, disappear, and go somewhere else?
I told you that dogs weave a spell over leprechauns.
Then why don't you let me help you?
Go away, lad! I don't want your help!
How come?
Because I can't! Would somebody be kind enough to help a poor man in trouble?
Sure.
Wait, Dad. Don't anybody help him. Mrs. Tresker.
You wouldn't. Say you won't, lad. It's not fair.
What is it, Quentin?
I'd like you to sing for us, if you don't mind.
Oh, how sweet of you to ask.
Oh, you're being cruel, lad.
Don't mind him, Mrs. Tresker.
Here. Hold precious.
You're a shrewd lad, Quentin. It's not often someone can figure out the law of the leprechauns.
Now, I know saving you has something to do with solving the money problem. But how?
When a leprechaun is rescued by the same person twice, that person is granted one more wish.
Hey, great!
But I'll be punished for allowing it to happen. I must give up something that means an awful lot to me.
What is it?
Your friendship, lad. You see, now I have to return to Ireland. I'll never be able to come back to see you again.
I'm gonna miss you.
I said I'd be leaving you, not forgetting you.
I won't forget you, Edith.
Well, go ahead.
Huh?
Your wish. Your new wish, lad.
I wish all the money in the world would return to where it belongs.
I'll be on my way now.
I should have never wished for all the money in the world.
Oh, never mind, son. If wishing was against the law, everybody would be in jail.
Oh, Quentin, a messenger came by last night. He left something for you in the barn.
What is it?
It's a surprise of sorts. Why don't you go and have a look for yourself?
Hi, Rosalind. Hi, Vincent.
There's something important we want to tell you.
Oh, yeah?
We were hiding near the barn. We heard what Flan said about how much your friendship meant to him. We're sorry we let money get in the way of our friendship. Yeah, it was dumb.
Thanks. Hey, come on. Mom says I have a surprise in here.
What's it say?
To Quentin, when one is good and honest, one is always rich. Thanks for your help, the President of the United States.
Gee, Quentin, that's really something.
Yeah, let's take a ride. Try it out.
Yeah, come on.
Let's go.
We'll return after these messages.
Hungry, hungry hippos, hungry, hungry hippos. If you want to win the game, you gotta take good aim and get the most marbles with your hippo. Playing hungry, hungry hippos. Hungry, hungry hippos.
Hungry, hungry hippos is the name of the game. And who's ever hippo gets the most marbles wins.
Playing hungry, hungry hippos. Hungry, hungry hippos.
Hungry, hungry hippos from Hasbro.
The return of the Jedi and the Underoos underwear spaceship.
We all love our Underoos, so many for you to choose.
Luke Skywalker at control.
Chewbacca.
And Han Solo standing by.
Boy Ewoks are brave.
Girl Ewoks are prettier. See? Princess Leia, on the lookout.
Introducing Point Dread and the Talon Fighter. Comes with adventure book and story record with sound effects. Action figures sold separately.
Let's hear He-Man, Skeletor, and the Point Dread story.
I, Skeletor, will finally defeat He-Man.
I'll use the Talon Fighter to stop Skeletor.
In a flash, He-Man's hurled through space and time.
Surrender to the power of Point Dread's Talon Fighter.
You win, He-Man, but I'll be back.
Point Dread and the Talon Fighter. With record and storybook, you have to put it together. Action figures sold separately from Mattel. Now, back to our story.
The chestnuts pop, 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 pop. There's a happy feeling nothing